So among the many victims of Hurricane Harvey are farmers and ranchers who live and work just outside the Houston metropolitan area. Tomeka Weatherspoon of Houston Public Media went to one ranch to learn about the damage and the recovery efforts.
Thousands of acres drowned in a lake of flood water.
It was just worse than we ever could have imagined.
These shots are from last week in Wharton County, Texas, just an hour southwest of Houston, where somewhere around 60,000 cattle are usually roaming around. But after weathering record-breaking rainfall and Tropical Storm Harvey, ranchers like John Locke emerged from the storm and were devastated when they couldn't find their cattle.
That was my entire livelihood out there. That was our entire herd of cattle. So we went to bed that night thinking there was a good possibility that we'd lost everything.
But they didn't. A desperate search by helicopter, and they found the missing cattle, hundreds of them stuck in rainwater and massive spillover from the Colorado River.
What we didn't account for is the resiliency of these animals and how smart they are. And we found them in places where, we don't know how they got there, but basically they swam to higher ground.
Rancher Coleman Locke, John's father, says he's never seen anything like this flood.
Where we're walking right now, the water would have been about thigh deep on me, probably about at least 2 feet deep here, and you can actually see where the water ran across the road and cut grooves in the gravel. So this was all totally underwater.
Now, it does flood in this area from time to time, but between the rain and the river, this time around, it's completely disrupted the rancher's way of life.
I know my son's been out there in the water for 2 days, at least waist deep, working, trying to either move cows to higher ground or get hay to them and see that they're okay.
A big priority right now is just getting to the cattle so the animals don't starve. First, the ranchers used airboats, but now at a middle point between flooded and dry, they're working in hard dirt. Pools of dirty water and deep mud.
We're on a larger area. We're dealing with ground that doesn't support equipment, doesn't support horses. So we're gonna try to get this hay out there. I've got about three different ideas of okay, if this doesn't work, we're gonna do this, and if this doesn't work, we're gonna do this.
All of this land should dry fast in the Texas heat, making the task much easier. But even the cattle are worn out from this whole ordeal. It'll be weeks before days on the ranch are back to normal.
We see this river flood about once every 10 to 15 years, which it flooded twice last year. And I'd say on a scale of a 1 to 10, a normal flood is a 2. This time we prepared for a 6, and what we saw was about a 12. But every day we go, it gets better, and every time the sun comes up, things get a little bit better, and we're moving in the right direction. We just have to keep holding on.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Tomeka Weatherspoon in Egypt, Texas.